Narcolepsy is a chronic sleep-wake disorder which classically causes the tetrad of excessive daytime sleepiness, cataplexy, which describes sudden muscle weakness that can lead to collapse, dreamlike hallucinations, and sleep paralysis. Disease onset is usually in a person's 20s, although it can be diagnosed at any age. Importantly, narcolepsy isn't actually that rare, being the second commonest cause of disabling daytime sleepiness after obstructive sleep apnea. Its estimated prevalence is about 1 in 1,000. Most of the cases of narcolepsy are sporadic. However, there are familial clusterings suggesting either a genetic or environmental link. The disease can be classified into type 1 and type 2 narcolepsy. Type 1 is caused by extensive neuron loss in the hypothalamus. These specific neurons produce orexin, also referred to as hypocretin, which is a neuropeptide that stabilizes the sleep and wake stages and prevents inappropriate transitions between them. As a result, this type is associated with very low levels of orexin and severe symptoms including cataplexy. Type 2 has normal orexin levels, including most of the same symptoms, but doesn't have cataplexy. The process that destroys the orexin-producing neurons remains a bit of a mystery, but more than 98% of people with type 1 narcolepsy have the HLA-DQB1 gene. This suggests there might be an autoimmune element to it. Let's discuss the main clinical features. All patients with narcolepsy have excessive daytime sleepiness. This can be associated with memory problems and attention issues, resulting in incidents like car crashes. The Epworth Sleepiness Scale can be used for evaluating excessive daytime sleepiness. People with narcolepsy are also prone to sleep attacks. These occur in inappropriate situations several times a day, even when fully involved in a task, and last between 1 minute and 1 hour. In addition to sleepiness, narcolepsy also characterized by disordered regulation of rapid eye movement sleep. REM sleep normally occurs only during the usual sleep period and includes vivid story-like dreams, rapid eye movements, and paralysis of nearly all skeletal muscles except the muscles of respiration. In narcolepsy, REM sleep can actually occur at any time of the day, intruding into wakefulness. The most severe manifestation of this is cataplexy, which occurs in 60% of patients. This is a generalized muscle weakness leading to partial or complete collapse. It is most frequently triggered by emotional stimuli such as laughter, excitement, or anger. Speech may be impaired, vision might be blurred, and respiration might become irregular during the attack. Many people with narcolepsy also complain of sleep paralysis, which occurs at the borders of sleep, typically when waking up. This is often associated with dreamlike and often disturbing hallucinations. Hallucinations that occur at the onset of sleep are referred to as hypnagogic hallucinations, and those that occur on awakening are referred to as hypnopompic hallucinations. Typical hallucinations might include the sense that a threatening stranger is in the bedroom or that one's being attacked by animals. Moving to investigations, the clinical history of narcolepsy often makes the diagnosis apparent, but it's essential to confirm it with overnight polysomnography, followed by multiple sleep latency tests the next day. The PSG ascertains sleep quality and can identify coexisting causes of excessive daytime sleepiness, such as OSA. In people with narcolepsy, it might show fragmented light sleep and an early transition into REM sleep. The MSLT is performed the day after. In this test, the patient is encouraged throughout the day to fall asleep every 2 hours for 20 minutes. Given the opportunity to nap, people with narcolepsy usually fall asleep in less than 8 minutes, whereas healthy people generally fall asleep in more than 15 minutes. In addition, people with narcolepsy will have REM sleep during at least 2 of these daytime naps. The management of narcolepsy is based on lifestyle modifications and medications to treat excessive daytime sleepiness and cataplexy. Non-pharmacological approaches should include improving sleep hygiene by adopting a relatively strict sleep schedule and avoiding alcohol, smoking, late-night exercise, and sleep deprivation. Excessive daytime sleepiness can be managed with CNS stimulants. One first-line medication is modafinil. Other medications, including dexamphetamine and methylphenidate like Ritalin, have evidence, but a lack of head-to-head trials makes it difficult to compare efficacy between drugs. Cataplexy is usually managed with sodium oxybate or pitocin. These reduce the frequency of attacks per week. Second-line agents such as serotonin noradrenaline reuptake inhibitors or tricyclic antidepressants can also be considered. To remember the classic triad of clinical symptoms for narcolepsy, remember CHESS features, including cataplexy, hallucinations, excessive somnolence, and sleep paralysis. If you like this mnemonic, then check out some of my other videos in this playlist. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to Townsend Teachings.